This is part three in a series that I'm doing to try to explain how I came to get the kinds of information that I got about this reptilian race who's been running the show for thousands of years. I want to clear up something right from the start. Many people think that certain world leaders are reptilians. This is not exactly true. The world leaders have a reptilian symbiote cloaked within them. This is why genetic manipulation is so important to this hidden race. In order for this astral form of a reptilian to be able to inhabit a human being, they have to have the right DNA. So while these individuals do have reptilian characteristics, they in themselves are not reptilians. They are humans. They are simply being managed and used by the reptilian within. What I'm trying to do is to show you how I came to know about this hidden reptilian race that's been controlling our planet for thousands of years, and how they've strung an electromagnetic frequency barrier around the planet, extending from the planet Mars, which they own. They also own the moon, and it is a staging area for them. They work interdimensionally, and they move between the physical and the astral worlds. In the astral world, they move about openly. In the physical world, they are cloaked within people in positions of power who have the right DNA and the right dispositions. This includes most of our world leaders. I'm just going to ask you to put aside judgments for the next few minutes and tuck this information into a part of your mind and let it stay there. If things play out the way I say, I think you'll recognize what I'm going to be telling you, and it may be very helpful to you. That's all I ask, just to listen and file this away somewhere. Thousands, maybe many thousands of years ago, a battle was waged in the heavens, and the earth became the prize of a reptilian race. They were very technologically advanced even way back then. They strung a net around the earth. It emanates from Mars and incorporates the moon also. This force field is what has been keeping us in prison here, as well as the people in the astral world. It also shuts down our higher knowing and blocks our view of many of the events that are happening out in space and are invisible to us. The reptilians came here because this was a planet ripe for picking. They happen to be carnivores, and human meat is their food of choice. They also ingest our energy in various ways. Now, I know this sounds crazy to a lot of people, but it is simply the truth. That is why they are here. And Planet X is the reason that there is suddenly a huge increase in UFO sightings. The reptilians know that they are going to be seen, exposed, and they are going to have a big battle on their hands, because our allies, primarily Pleiadian and Sirian, are coming in with Planet X. They are going to be routing out this reptilian race, and the Creator has declared they are going into a hell dimension to pay for what they have done here. Now, this is the warnings. As as chaos ensues when the planet is first seen, they will encourage a number of things that could be very, very harmful. One of them will be to encourage people to go to these huge underground bases. Please do not go there. This will be your death. They will also invite certain people to go aboard craft, UFOs of various types that they have. This will also be a disaster for anyone who goes. They will create false raptures. This is something we've known about for a long time in the UFO field. It is called Project Blue Beam. These will be holographic images, and they will haul people up into their ships. Please do not fall for this. As much as possible, stay calm and stay put, because we are going to see the whole facade unravel. We're going to see the reptilian race. We're going to see the net, and the planet is what is bringing this about. Planet X is our prison break. Don't fight against the allies who are coming in escorting Planet X. They are here to help us, but the reptilian controlled media will convince people that these are negative and to fight against them. Please do not do this. Hold off. Stay calm. Remember what I've said. Pull it up. When you start to see things going crazy, and just remember, we're going to have an incredible future. We're going to finally be free of this vile race that has butchered and tortured so many. It's going to be a psychological shock when we see what has been going on behind the scenes. But afterwards, there'll be tremendous healing, tremendous help. We are going to have our Eden back. This planet will be beautiful again, and life will turn around in ways we cannot even imagine right now. And there will be panic once it is seen, and the reptilians can no longer keep it hidden from our view with their electromagnetic frequency barrier that is called the net. This panic, if it is not at least tempered, will result in a lot more harm being done to people here. I'm trying to help keep that from happening. The way it will happen, I will be laying this out as I go along, because I've listened to these reptilians. Believe me, I got their attention and they showed up. They have been in my life now for about 5 years. I know who they are, and I know what they're planning. And the whole reason for my exposing this is not to put people into fear, is not to sound like I'm negative or crazy, but to try to save people from more harm and more death, more suffering. So now I'm going to continue with this. And so I was just pulling out all the stops. I just could not quite figure out what was happening until I picked up a book called The Reptilians Came Here Because This Was a Planet Ripe for Picking. Volume 2, Human Meat, is their food of choice. Part four, we're going crazy. I really didn't know what to do about it except pray, and I prayed a lot. I prayed to whoever would listen. I didn't care if it was Jesus or Buddha or angels or saints or God himself. I was praying, and I wanted somebody to help these people, to try to understand how things got so bad, and how it's just so, I don't know, it seemed very, if this was supposed to be teaching people a lesson, I wasn't getting it, and they weren't either. I was looking into a lot of different books. I was reading UFO material, for which I was very familiar. I'd been involved in UFO TV and radio for about 14 years. And so I was just pulling out all the stops. I just could not quite figure out what was happening until I picked up Reptilian Characteristics. This is why genetic manipulation is so important to this hidden race. And they are going to have a big battle on their hands.